Hello friends, so in pharmacognosy the first topic we have covered, that is adulteration and drug evaluation. Now the next one is from the pharmacological groups, two more important groups are remaining. So first group today we will cover, and that is CNS depressants, or they are also called drugs acting on nervous system. Now in this category 9 drugs are there, and before studying the cognostic study of these drugs, first we will see that how these drugs exert or produce their effect on nervous system. Now regarding nervous system, you will learn about its anatomy and physiology in Human Anatomy and Physiology subject. Here we must know that nervous system is the main important system of the body, and it is divided in two main divisions, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, isn't it? Okay, now here again, peripheral nervous system, that is afferent nerves and efferent nerves, and the central nervous system is divided into brain and spinal cord, isn't it? Now CNS, that is the central nervous system, is associated with all voluntary actions, okay, and many of the responses due to proper coordination between autonomic and central nervous system. Now this autonomic nervous system, as I said, peripheral nervous system is divided in afferent and efferent nerves, and these efferent nerves are divided into autonomic nervous system and somatic, that is we can again say autonomic, which is involuntary, and somatic, which is voluntary, okay, and then autonomic, that is divided into two portions, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, okay. And in our body, whatever these divisions are there of nervous system, they work in our body in coordination, isn't it? Now different natural drugs, they are effective on CNS, isn't it? And they are analgesics, okay, that is painkillers. So the painkillers show their effect on nervous system. Then analeptics, that is the stimulants. So either they may be CNS stimulants, there are respiratory stimulants, isn't it? That means they stimulate the overall activity of that particular system. And drugs affecting mental activity, isn't it? So either they may be used as stimulants or depressants or hallucinogens, okay. Now autonomic nervous system, as I said, that there are two divisions, sympathetic and parasympathetic, isn't it? Now this autonomic nervous system controls the functions, isn't it? You can refer this slide also, but I will explain you in simple way that whatever the vegetative functions are there of our body, now these vegetative functions are like respiration that is going on, circulation of the blood, digestion of food, isn't it? Maintenance of body, okay, temperature. So these are the vegetative functions, isn't it? And all these are controlled by autonomic nervous system, and this autonomic nervous system has got two divisions, isn't it? Sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Now parasympathetic nervous system is associated with conservation and restoration of energy, isn't it? Like the gastrointestinal motility and whatever the secretions are there in GI tract, they are all governed by parasympathetic nervous system. Then slowing of the heart rate and lowering blood pressure also is under control of parasympathetic nervous system. On other hand, sympathetic nervous system is associated with the alertness or arousal effects, and both these systems, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, they are opposite to each other, isn't it? They work in our body totally opposite, isn't it? These effects of sympathetic nervous system are increase in heart rate, increase in blood sugar, increase in blood pressure also, vascular effects. Okay. Now, whatever these two systems are there, so in our body there are many chemicals which are released, and similarly in these two systems also two main important neurotransmitters are there, or chemical transmitters we can call. Now in case of parasympathetic nervous system, acetylcholine is the main chemical transmitter which is released, isn't it, due to stimulation of parasympathetic nervous system, isn't it? And the stimulant activity which is taking place in our body due to acetylcholine is called cholinergic activity, because the effects or the activities that are taking place due to the release of acetylcholine, all they are called as cholinergic effects. On other hand, in case of sympathetic nervous system, noradrenaline or adrenaline we can call are the chemical transmitters which are released due to stimulation of sympathetic nervous system. So whatever the activities are taking place due to adrenaline in our body, they are called adrenergic effects or adrenergic activity, isn't it? So these points you have to remember, that both these divisions, they have got opposite effect, they work totally opposite to each other, the neurotransmitters are different in both the divisions, isn't it? And therefore in this topic, that is the drugs acting on nervous system, isn't it, they have got somewhat either similar effects to acetylcholine or opposite effect to acetylcholine, or these drugs may have similar effect to noradrenaline or opposite effect to noradrenaline, and then accordingly they are called cholinergic drugs, because they will have similar effect to that of acetylcholine, and they are referred as cholinergic drugs. But the drugs which will block the effect of acetylcholine, isn't it, they will be called cholinergic blockers or antagonist of acetylcholine. So these points you have to understand very carefully to understand this topic, that the drugs may have either similar effect to that of acetylcholine or opposite effect to that of acetylcholine. So the drugs which have similar effect, they are called cholinergic drugs. The drugs which have opposite effect to that of acetylcholine, they are called cholinergic blockers. Also, the drugs which have similar effect to that of noradrenaline, they are called adrenergic drugs, the drugs which have blocking effect on adrenaline, they are called adrenergic blockers or antagonist of adrenaline. So these four categories of drugs you will find in this topic. Now, one by one, as I said, there are 9 drugs. So in this category, the cognostic study of 9 drugs we will cover. The first one is hyoscyamus. Now this hyoscyamus is alkaloid containing drug. It is organized drug. The synonym is hyoscyamus herb. Hyoscyamus leaves also is another synonym. And henbane. These are 3 important other names for hyoscyamus. It is organized drug. Biological source. It consists of dried leaves and flowering tops of the plant of the species Hyoscyamus niger. It belongs to Solanaceae family. As I said, that it is a alkaloid containing drug. Chemical constituents are, it contains mainly alkaloids, and the main alkaloids are hyoscyamine, hyoscine. The other name for hyoscine is scopolamine and atropine. These 3 alkaloids are present, isn't it? Main important uses are, it is used as antispasmodic, expectorant and antihistamine. So antispasmodic, now again we can say that the spasm is produced in the body, and spasm we can say it is a pain, but here when we say spasm, so it is the pain of either voluntary muscles or involuntary muscles. So the drugs which relieve spasm, that is pain of muscles, may be voluntary or involuntary, they are called antispasmodics, isn't it? So it is antispasmodic, it has an expectorant effect, anti-asthmatic, used in asthma. It also it is used to counteract gripping effect due to purgatives, isn't it? Next is Datura leaves. This is also a organized drug. Datura herb is a synonym. Some other synonyms also you can see on this slide. Thorn apple, isn't it? Or Jamestown wood. But simply Datura herb is also another name which is used interchangeably. This is also a alkaloid containing drug. And these are tropane alkaloid containing drugs, isn't it? We have seen the chemical nature alkaloids, their definition, classification, isn't it? So the slide also shows the leaves, you can see, isn't it? And there are different varieties, isn't it? Biological sources, it consists of dried leaves and flowering tops of Datura metal, isn't it? The other species is Datura stramonium, and family is Solanaceae. Chemical constituents which are present in this drug, it contains alkaloids, and the main alkaloids that are present are hyoscine, That is the another name for Iosin is scopolamine, isn't it? Atropine and hyoscyamine. So in three drugs we will see third one also, that is hyoscyamus, datura and belladonna. All these are tropane alkaloid containing drugs, and all three they belong to solanaceae family. And also these contain three main alkaloids that we are discussing, that is hyoscine, hyoscyamine and atropine. But the percentage of these three alkaloids is different in all these three drugs. Uses: Datura, it is a parasympathetic depressant. Now earlier I have cleared that the four different types of drugs can be seen in this category. We know that there are two divisions of autonomic nervous system, that is parasympathetic division and sympathetic division. In parasympathetic division, acetylcholine is the main neurotransmitter. So either the drugs may have similar effect to that of acetylcholine, they are called cholinergic drugs, and the drugs which have opposite effect to acetylcholine, they are called cholinergic blockers. So these drugs also we can call parasympathetic depressants, isn't it? They will depress the effect of acetylcholine, isn't it? So they are useful in treatment of asthma and cough. This drug is antispasmodic. It is a depressant of central nervous system, isn't it? They are also effective in duodenal ulcers, isn't it? And in ophthalmology also they are useful, isn't it? That is the atropine and hyoscine, they are used in ophthalmic practice for dilatation of pupil, isn't it? So in duodenal ulcers also they are useful. So as I said that there are three drugs which are tropane alkaloid containing drugs. Two we have covered, hyoscyamus, datura, and third one is belladonna. Now this belladonna also, it is a organized drug, okay? And the other name for belladonna is belladonna leaf, belladonna folium, deadly nightshade is another name for belladonna. Biological sources, it consists of dried leaves and other aerial parts of the species Atropa belladonna. The other species is Atropa acuminata, isn't it? And it belongs to Solanaceae family. Chemical constituents are: it contains alkaloids, and three main alkaloids that are present are hyoscine, hyoscyamine, but in this we will see that the main alkaloid that is present, isn't it, is scopolamine, and the other name for scopolamine is beta methyl esculatine. The another important alkaloid is belladonin, isn't it? Uses of the drug: prithi, again a parasympathetic depressant, isn't it, as we have discussed in datura leaf. It is a cholinergic blocker. It is used to reduce secretions like salivary secretion, the other secretions of gastric glands, isn't it? It also reduces secretion of sweat. It is a spasmolytic, that is antispasmodic we can say. especially in intestinal pain, isn't it? It is also useful as an antidote in poisoning due to opium, isn't it? It causes dryness of mouth and skin because the secretions are reduced, isn't it? We have seen that it is a cholinergic blocker. So when cholinergic blockers are taken, they reduce most of the secretions of the body and they result in dryness of mouth and skin. Next drug is aconite. This is also a organized drug. Roots are important. Synonym is aconite root. Other synonym for aconite is monkhood. Biological source, it consists of tuberous roots obtained from the plant Aconitum napellus. It belongs to family Ranunculaceae. It is an alkaloid containing drug. Chemical constituents are, it contains alkaloids, mainly ether soluble alkaloids and ether insoluble alkaloids. The ether soluble alkaloids are aconitine, aconine, mesaconitine, hypoconitine, neopaline, napelline and neoline. Other important constituents are starch, aconitic acid and succinic acid. Uses of the drug. Aconitine is externally used in treatment of neuralgia, sciatica, rheumatism and inflammation. It is an analgesic and cardiac depressant drug. It has got poisonous effect also, toxic effect you can say, due to aconitine content. Next drug is ashwagandha. It is a organized drug. You can see the roots in the slide, isn't it? Other name of the drug is Vidania roots, ashwagandha, Asgand, other name for ashwagandha. Biological sources, it consists of dried roots and stem bases obtained from the species Vidania somnifera, belonging to family Solanaceae. Chemical constituents, it contains alkaloids and important are cuscohygrine, tropine, pseudotropine, enafarine, then vidasomnin and vesamin are newer alkaloids which are isolated from the drug. Now the plant is also reported to contain very important group of C28 steroids. They are called vidanolides, and in this vidafarin A is the most important constituent which has got antibiotic and anti-tumor activity. Uses of the drug, it is a very good hypotensive. So hypotensive also we can call as a anti-hypertensive drug. It is a depressant drug. It has got antispasmodic activity, anthelmintic, isn't it? So the main action of the drug is on smooth muscles. It is used in asthma. It is a uterine sedative, isn't it? It also acts as a tonic and useful in anti-tumor treatment. Next drug is ephedra. It is a Chinese drug, organized drug. Only one other name is there, that is Ma Hong. Biological sources: it consists of dried young stems obtained from the species Ephedra gerardiana or Ephedra nevrodensis. It belongs to family Ephedraceae. In some books it is given Nitaceae. So the spelling is from G, but the pronunciation is Nitaceae. Chemical constituents are: it contains alkaloids, and the main important alkaloid in the drug is ephedrine, isn't it? Other important drugs are methyl ephedrine, methyl isoephedrine, pseudoephedrine, norephedrine, dimethyl ephedrine. These are all important, we can say, alkaloids which are present in the drug. Uses of the drug: it is a very good drug which is useful in providing relief in asthma. It is beneficial in hay fever and whooping cough also, that is pertussis. It is a sympathomimetic drug. So this term is also used for the drugs which are called adrenergic drugs, isn't it? So which have similar effect to that of adrenaline, isn't it? It is also used for extraction of ephedrine. So ephedrine can be extracted from the drug. And the advantage of this drug is that not necessarily it is given by parenteral route, but it can be given orally also. Next drug is opium. It is a narcotic analgesic, and it is called afim, afu. The other name for the drug is raw opium. So you can see in the slide, isn't it? It is a narcotic drug, and the cultivation, collection and possession of the drug is under the strict control of government authorities, isn't it? So without prior permission, nobody can go for the cultivation of opium. Other name is raw opium. Biological sources: it consists of dried latex obtained from unripe capsules of the plant Papaver somniferum. Family is Papaveraceae. It is a alkaloid containing drug. We'll see the main chemical constituents. So near about important 25 alkaloids are present in the drug, and they are combined with meconic acid. Now the alkaloids are divided in two classes pharmacologically. One is narcotic alkaloids and other are non-narcotic alkaloids. So alkaloids, we have seen the classification also based on the ring that is present in the drug, isn't it? So phenanthrene derivatives are present in this, and benzyl isoquinoline derivatives. The important alkaloids which are present in this are morphine. Morphine is the main important narcotic analgesic alkaloid. Other alkaloids are codeine, nascopine, narcotine, thebaine and papaverine, isn't it? These are important alkaloids present in the drug. uses are that opium is a analgesic, hypnotic or narcotic. So hypnotic drugs, the drugs which produce sleep, and that sleep resembles natural sleep, that is called hypnotic. And narcotic means which produces narcosis, nasha. Now the codeine alkaloid which is present in the drug, it is useful as expectorant. So most of the syrups which are present in the market, they contain codeine phosphate. They are used in cough and bronchitis. Papaverin alkaloid is a spasmolytic in action, isn't it? And narcotin is a respiratory stimulant. Okay, these are important uses associated with opium. Other drug is cannabis. So the other simple name is ganja, isn't it? This is also under the control of government authorities. Nobody can go for cultivation, collection and possession of the drug, isn't it? And it has got few more main important other names, isn't it? So cannabis indica, Indian hemp, ganja, hashish, isn't it? Marijuana, marijuana, these are important other names of the drug. Biological sources, that cannabis consists of dried flowering tops obtained from the cultivated plant of Cannabis sativa belonging to family Cannabinaceae, or in some books it is given Moraceae. So any one name you can write down, family is Cannabinaceae or Moraceae. Chemical constituents which are present, so this drug contains resin, isn't it? And it is a euphoric principle, euphoria producing. Euphoria means sense of well-being, isn't it? So volatile oil, fixed oil, trigonelline, choline, resin, as I said, it is present. And important constituents are cannabinol, cannabigerol, cannabidiolic acid, isn't it? Uses, so it is a narcotic, sedative and analgesic. It is a psychotropic drug, isn't it? The main constituent that is present in the drug, we have seen resin, that is THC, tetrahydrocannabinol, isn't it? It produces euphoria, sense of well-being, isn't it? And mental disturbances also can be seen due to this drug. So last drug we will see is Naxomica. You are knowing, all of you, about Naxomica. The section you have performed, transverse section of Naxomica seed, it is an organized drug, isn't it? The synonym for the drug is crow fig, Siemens trichni, isn't it? Two main important other names are there, crow fig seed, Siemens trichni. Biological sources, Naxomica consists of dried ripe seeds obtained from the plant Strychnus naxomica belonging to family Loganiaceae, and it is a alkaloid containing drug. Chemical constituents, now this Naxomica, it contains bitter indol alkaloids, isn't it? And the main alkaloids are strychnine and brucine, while other important alkaloids are vomicine, अल्फा कोलुब्रिन, सुडोस्ट्रिशनिन, स्ट्रिशनिसिन, isn't it? These are important alkaloids that are present in the drug. Uses, so due to its bitter taste, Naxomica is used as bitter stomachic and tonic. It is stimulant to central nervous system. It increases blood pressure. It is recommended in certain forms of cardiac failure. It stimulates respiratory and cardiovascular system. So these are important uses of Naxomica. So with this we finish up the pharmacognostic study of CNS depressants or drugs acting on nervous system. So in this 9 drugs we have covered. Go through this cognostic study, try to revise, practice it so that you can easily remember. Thank you.